Hello, so now we will be trying to convert IP addresses to binary number and then convert the binary into a decimal number and then also figuring out the network address in binary and then subnet mask in binary, the prefix link and the network address, especially the network portion and the host portion. Okay, so first let's do this one. 1A. Okay, I will write here. So it's A. So first of all, why should we convert the decimal value, the IP addresses to binary number? It's because we need to use the binary system because it's a language used by the computer, so that the computer can understand that. So first, these numbers. So let's take 201 first. So it's bigger than 128. So it's 1 here. 128. 373. It's bigger than 64. We put 1 here. It's 9. Smaller than 32, smaller than 16, bigger than 8, and 001. Okay, and we'll do the other numbers as well. 17, it's smaller, it's bigger than 16, so we put 1, and then we got 1 left, we put here. Let's do 29. It's smaller. It's bigger than 16. And then we get 13. It's bigger than 8. We put 1. We get 5. It's bigger than 4. And we get 1 left. Okay, so get 4. Smaller. So this is the decimal number, the binary number, I mean, that we got. Okay, so we'll put here, type A, it is, Okay, so we got A. Let's do the same for the next one. For B. I did it first. Let's do it. B 192.168.1.1. It's the same. Good. 192 first. It's bigger than 128. Let's subtract that. 24. We get 5. 54. It's smaller than 64. So it's 0. It's bigger than 32. But here, 22. It's bigger than 16. 16. We get 6. More than 4, so it's 0. Okay, we get it. And let's do 168. It's bigger than 128. Here, 168. Okay, 40. It's more than 64. It's here. 8. 0, 1, 0, 0, 0. Okay, we get 168. Now let's do 1. Obviously, it's only fit in 1. And then it's the same for this one. Okay, let's put it here. So why should we have unique IP addresses? Why is you need to be unique across the end devices? So it's so that there will be no error, because if you try to assign a system of similar IP address which is already assigned in one system, there will be a display of IP conflict. So you cannot have the same IP addresses between end system. Okay, got one more. Let's see. Okay, so let's do it. 7200001 2. Oh, it's lagging. 16 32 64. So it's bigger than 128. 72 128. That's minus it 6 4, and then you get 4 44, and it's smaller than 64. It's bigger than 32. You get 12 0 1, and then 1 0 0. Okay, so for the rest, because it's all zeros, that means all zero then. I'll put it here. 1 1. Hit them. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Okay, so it's all done. We have finished converting the IP addresses to binary numbers. Okay, so now let's convert binary number into decimal number. Okay, so first let's here. Okay, so let's move here. Convert 1 1 0 0 1 1. So this one is 2 8 1 2 4 8 32 64 1 2 8. Wait, I skip 16 16 32. And then 64 1 2 8. So first we'll add the one that has 1 in it. So it's 128. So 64 plus 8 plus 4 is 2 plus 1. So let's compute it real quick. It's 128. So we get 207. So we'll put it here, 207. Then let's move on to the second set. Zero, 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 one, one, one. So 1 2 4. Okay, so we don't need to continue because it's all zero. So it's 7. put 7 here. And let's do this third string. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 2, 4, 8, 16. Let's compute 16 plus 18 plus 2. So we got 26. Then this one less. So we are adding 128 plus 32, which is 160. Okay, so we got the decimal number 160. Oh, I forgot to put a dot here. So this is the answer. And then here we got the network address. Network address 192.168.1.1. So what is the network address in binary? Okay, so because we already convert the binary number here, it's the same coincidentally. So we already got the answer to it. I copy it. Just put and then what is the subnet mask in the binary? So because it's 255, okay, we'll just do 1. So it's 255. Put on 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 28. So it's yeah. But was that 2, 27? Yes, 64. 3. And then 63. Speaker 63, 32, 1, 3, 31, 16, got 5, 15, 1, 15 minus 8, it is 7. So it's all 1. So what is the subnet mask? Why is it so important? Because it's to define the network portion and the host portion. Okay. So computer, they cannot recognize immediately. For example, this one, which one is the network portion, which one is the host portion. Okay. So we use subnet mask to let the computer know which one is the network portion and which one is the host portion. So I'm right here. The in binary 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, this A. I assume this one is 0. Okay, so it's all 0. Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so what is the prefix slang? Prefix slangs is the number of 1 here. So we got 8 multiplied by 3. So we got 24. Okay. So in the network address 192.168.1.1, underline the network portion and the host portion. So the way we know is by the subnet mask. Okay. So because the one is on the first, second, third, so we know the first, second, third is the network portion. So we will underline. Oh, this one is not underlined. So this one is, we will highlight it first. This one is for the network portion, and this one is for host portion. So we know by the subnet mask. If the subnet mask is something like this, so we know that the first and second is the network portion, and the third and fourth is the host portion. But it's not in this case. Okay, so I will just add yellow network portion, and then blue host portion. Okay, so that's it. Thank you so much. Take care.